Today, I want to bring you along as I review a very intense case of a dear patient of mine. We'll start off by looking at some MRIs of the cervical spine from about a year ago, May of 2022. So as I pull these scans up on the screen, I'm going to show you a sagittal view, which is a side view, as if we're chopping the guy like that. And on the left-hand side of the screen, we're going to show you the stir image, which lets us look at water as being bright. On the right-hand side, image from the same time, this is after the administration of contrast dye. And so what I'll show you here, again, with a stir image on the left and a post-contrast image on the right, is this guy's spinal cord from about a year ago. Now, he presented to me a few years back with a progressive myelopathic picture. That's doctor talk for cord involvement, although most of the cord involvement was in his thoracic spine. Now, what you can see here is the traces of some T2 bright lesions in his spine. And I want to show you on the right, there's no abnormal contrast enhancement. Again, most of his disease was actually lower down in his thoracic spine. And this was a pretty good looking scan. We were happy with it. Now, unfortunately, the gentleman came back to see me about a year later, and he wasn't doing okay. His walking had gotten much, much worse. He was very stiff in his legs, and he was having new difficulties controlling bowel and bladder. We got some new imaging, and I'm gonna show that to you now. So I'm fast forwarding time to May of 2023. And give me a second to get this set up so that I can show it to you. Again, I'm gonna use the same format where I put the stir image on the left. That's gonna show you water as bright. And then on the right-hand side, I'll pull up the side view after contrast. And this is what we got a year later when he was clinically very symptomatic. Give the computer time to catch up. So what you see on the left is very different from what I was showing you beforehand. We now have this significant bright spot right there, and there's another one here, and there's two more down here, and in the top of the thoracic spine, we see lesions as well. That's a very concerning MRI. And when you look on the other side of the screen after the contrast, there's now areas of contrast enhancement quite substantially. Let's see if I can window this a little better to make it easier for you guys to see. Give the computer time to catch up there. I want to remind you that this is a gentleman with primary progressive MS. He's never presented with an attack before. For those of you that are wondering, NMO, which is a mimic of MS, has been ruled out. And I feel very comfortable that this is in fact multiple sclerosis. Now, as I kind of scan across his cord, you can see enhancement here on the right and enhancement down here on the right. And there you can really see very significant enhancement, just kind of speckled all the way down his cervical spinal cord. And he was in a pretty bad way. Just to highlight this a little more, I'm going to change the pictures around to focus our attention on the contrast. So what I'm showing you now on the left is the cross section of the picture from the right. So on the left here, this is the contrasted image, and it'll just give us an opportunity to look at sections of those enhancing lesions. So you can see, as we look at the spinal cord here, areas of enhancement within this circle here. Really, really scary stuff to look at, guys. So we see enhancement over there. Those little white dots that I'm pointing out, there's a good example. I'll try to make that bigger to really highlight it. And this explains why he was having significant difficulties ambulating, why his legs were so stiff, why they were weak, and probably why he was having some of the difficulties that he had with the down there's. give you a couple more examples as we go lower on the spinal cord. And you can see this area of enhancement right there. Very, very concerning. So we gave him steroids, and I imaged him a month later. Fortunately, clinically, he had made quite an improvement. I would say he was about maybe 70% better. He still was having difficulties walking, but he wasn't nearly as spastic, and his down there's were working better. So bowel and bladder were intact. I'm showing you now the MRI from 1 month later. So this is June of 2023. And if the computer sees fit to allow me to show you these images, I'm going to put the stir image on the left. That's where the water is bright. And then on the right-hand side, I'll show you the contrasted study. So as we move across the cervical spine, this is the follow-up scan after the administration of steroids about a month later. And what you see now is the bright areas that we saw a month earlier were not completely gone, but largely gone. That was very reassuring. And on the right-hand side, the enhancement was not completely gone, but it was largely gone. There's just a couple areas. So here you see that bright spot, but you can see up above a lot of that's gone. And if you look over here on the right, there's a little area of enhancement where my cursor is, but largely it got better. So this is a case of a gentleman with primary progressive MS. Oftentimes we don't think of PPMS as having such a robust, scary presentation clinically and on MRI. This, however, is a real world situation. The gentleman continues to improve, and I just wanted to take a few minutes and share with you a real world situation. If you have questions about this case or about the imaging, please leave a comment down in the section below. And as always, until my next video, this is Aaron Boster saying be safe and take care.